So, welcome to a new video. Today I will show you some reverse engineering skills to have some fun with an application I often use. So, one big problem for me is to find a new name for my project or tool what I will develop. And there's one great page, Namelix. I hope I pronounced this right. You can enter some keywords. And then can customize something, and then it will create some icons and some project names. I sometimes use this to get a new project name for my things I want to do. But there's one problem. I often build Python package, and if you go back, you can check if the domain name is already available or if it's used by someone else, but you cannot check if it's already a Python package with this name. And I want to build a new project which uses this page to get the name, and then also check if a project name is available on PyPy. So how will we do this? We first will find out how the names will be generated. So we open the debugger from my browser. Then I think under network, this will show us all the requests they are built from, they are called from this site. And the first one will be interesting, because if you look inside the respond repost, you will see there are already some names. And I think if we get this running, as we can get some result from this endpoint, we will be able to build a Python package or Python script which called this endpoint and then get the data, and then we can process the data like we want. So let me check us. So first, before I start coding, I will get some information about this page, how we work, and the interesting part are the form data. There's a token. Interesting. So I think there's a program called Postman where you can send some requests to play with your endpoint. So let's look like this, and we can get a new. I will copy the URL. And if I send these post requests, I think I will get an error. So that means there is something missing, and I think we have to pass in the form data. I will quick do it, and then we will see you again. So I have entered all these values, and now let us see what is the result. And yes, we get a nice result. Let's check us in JSONs. Yes, and we can see there are some items that look other like the others, and I think we see some premium special values if I check out this inside my web browser. I think this will be in. Oh no. Oh. This will be this special item. So I think we can avoid this if we change maybe, yeah, if we delete this, maybe. Yes, now we have simple over Ypres. Over, it should be the same, but this can be check but out of Python. I'll be not sure why there are other. No, yes, it. Maybe there are some other sorting algorithm. Some other sorting of these items, I'm not sure, but I'm glad we have some simple results. Now we can go on and build up our Python project. Yes, I think we have enough information. We know the URL we want to know. We know the values we accept from the URL endpoint. And now we can go on and write a small script. So here we are, ready to start on your program. I will build up my package structure I have on my previous package I built, but for now I will create a simple file, only you can get some result. Set up. Virtual environment and install request. This will be the package we will use for send the request we want to have. So, and in the package we will import. Sorry. That's right. So we have to go back to our postman, get the URL. And print the result. Sorry for this. And we get a nice result, a response. So I think and then we will see the error because we don't have set the post values. I think we should something like this you can use. And I hope this will send the daughter as an and now we get the result. This was really simple. I have a JSON. We get the result as some already some data. Yeah, easy. Now we have loop through the data and look inside and get the name. So we can check, it's a list of dictionaries. And inside these dictionaries, there will be a title and a title split. And we will get this. So, for item, then you will get item from get Okay, and here we are. These are our names. So if I remove this, I'm not sure if I need this. Let's get the void of these well names, or this name with them. This name with them .com extension. Yeah, it was simple. Maybe I will check how the this. No, it was the postman. I will look up what we get from this. And maybe we make an empty line so we get a nice structure. Yeah, okay, I think if I change the type, I think this is a style, if we change this type, we get multiple names, not only a single name, and I'm not sure why we need these. Maybe you can check this out. So the next step is we will look how this value will change if I change, for example, the length, which we call in our new, maybe have cleared before, too late. So we have short, medium, and long. I'm not sure how we can. Well, let's play with this. My problem, I don't have the same name of the key of this dictionary. So this will be an error because we have, this will not be an error. I think this should be. No. Anyway, print this. I was thinking this should be got an error, but I'm wrong. Length short. Yeah, but you see, I only have length short, of course. This will give an error. Okay, so now I'm not confused. So this will give an error. I'm not sure how I can clean this up, but maybe it's okay if we have only one, and then we can make multiple requests of a endpoint, and then we can see the results. So this is medium, and then we have long, I think. Right? Oh, was it something else? Let me quick check. No, it looks like this is okay. So this was the length of our name. Now extension, yeah, but we won't check them, so I'm not sure that we need this. No, everything worked fine, so go back to short because I like short. Now we can we'll look at the styles. And I think I'm not sure. Ah, okay, if we change the style, I remember what I have said. So going back to the so multiple words. What can I read? So this will be multiple words, huh? And now, yeah, here we got a RubyX. So I'm not sure for why we need this, but only one name. So this could be a blank, or how did it look in the browser? Yeah, it's in the end. Yeah, it's okay. So we have found out all these. I think it could be easier by looking here. So we got this is brand, we know it. Multiple words. Language. I will quick copy them to my script so I don't have to. So I have all in one place. And after that, I will create a function who will call the endpoint with a different values we can pass through this endpoint. Yeah, okay, this is our basic setup, which was quite easy and didn't take that much. Before I will make a nice Python package, I have already checked the I have already to check if a name is available on PyPy. So I will quick make a function, really simple function. I think something like this. Yeah, like a default. So I can change this later if I don't know why I do this, but and pass into these. Oh, sorry. Keyboard styles. Define the default style like brandable length, like short. And we were all at make so data will be copy. So there's a function. Oh, we have to enter the and there it is. I think this should be run. Yes. And now we need a second function where check name IP. So then we can say this will be the names. Count names. So should I return all of these or only the name? How I write this right? And there. So for name, so now it's a generator. Can do this. Print name. And we can check name. So now it's everything true. True, true, true. Or we make it. So everything will be true, and now we have to check if it's available in PyPy. But, I don't know if there's already a package, should I check this? So there's a packet called check PyPy name. We can try it. So we can import. From so we have to make these. Sorry. And simple run this. None. I think none is. It's not a variable. And if it's true, it should be variable. So let me check if it's working right. If I call okay. Check PyPy. Oh, I have. So if I run this with pip, this should be available. Print can't delete this. So now, none. It looks like the package won't work. I think if I look inside the source, there's an old host. So maybe we have to change this. Let me look how this works. So let's look inside this. Yeah, this is true. So old package we have to define these. And now we can look. True. False, false. As I accept most of this name will be not as for Python package. Yeah, here's one. Interesting. Let us check this out and see if it's already if it's true that's taken. So there was it. True. So if you go to Pipey, I think, or is it Comedy? Oh. Yeah, and these packages, something that's original. So yeah, I think my basic structure of this project worked fine. So now I will make it a little bit nicer, set up a setup script and all these parts. We need to have a Python package, but I think it's not that interesting to have to watch. I will make it fast forward, so we will see you soon. Hey, thanks for already watching. So you see, takes a lot of time to build the package, but there's nothing special. I think there are a lot of good tutorials online. You can check them out. Yeah, thanks for watching. I will let this run through. And don't forget to like and subscribe. I hope I can make more videos with more and better content. So please share this video and we will see you